Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Wargaming.net League Gold Series. My name is Benjamin Breaker Novotny.
This is Edison 99.
And tonight, unfortunately, we have to bring you guys some bad news. Front Mission has unfortunately been disqualified because they didn't have enough of their team members in the designated channel at the designated time. Therefore, we cannot actually put them in tonight's game. We cannot field them as players.
And the winner will still be the team efficiency because of that's the second time, I think.
That's the second time. Did team efficiency get a free win before?
Yep. Another team is...
Was it Elong?
No. Singapore team. Oh, no. The first one is Elong versus
that was the
Shell
first
Tiger.
One.
And the Shell Tiger's winner, right? Elong failed to report. And on the Tuesday, last week, I forgot which day. Also, the team efficiency.
Yeah.
Versus TCSG, I think.
Well, I wonder if team efficiency is going to get walkovers all the way to the season finals.
Yeah,
maybe.
Yeah, got two, you know.
Yeah.
But I think for such a strong team, they don't worry about that. I mean, they don't want to get a free win. Maybe they want to touch a chance for the practice, you know.
Before we dive into the rules, I just want to mention that, you know, I feel like Team Efficiency is the more favorite team of the two teams. But the reason why we play these games is because you guys want to show, and it's fair to the players. We don't say, get off the stage, we know you guys are going to lose. That's just
me. No. I'm not talking about that because of every team, they got a chance to win, even they passed to the Team Efficiency, you know. And the formation, they're doing really nice on this season, you know.
That is right. I mean, they've beaten One Blood, who actually had a nearly flawless nearly flawless killing spree through the Silver Series in season two. But and they beat PvP Super Friends, although that was the tiebreaker game.
Yep. Tiebreaker to Shadow Tiger.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That was not bad.
Yeah. Also okay. Good, but you know, on the game night, they are not doing that good, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Just, they weren't there. All right, so now we're diving into the rules, guys. If this is your first time watching, there are only two types of team rosters that are available. That would be the 5-8-7 composition, which is 5 tier 8 tanks and 2 tier 7s, or the 6-8-6 composition, that would be 6 tier 8s and 1 tier 6. One match will consist of two maps and a maximum of 8 battles. That is to say, 4 rounds on each map. That would be 4 rounds on map 1, 4 rounds on map 2. And the roles are played according to the following rule. That's attack, attack, defense, defense. And to win the match, each team needs to win 5 battles out of 8. If one team gets 5 wins, the remaining battles are not played. If in the event, we should see a 4-4. We take things into a tiebreaker game where the winning team gets 2 points, the losing team gets 1 point. If one team makes it to 5 points before the other, the winning team gets 3 points. All right, so now we're going to take things into the standings. First gold series. Let's see if the production crew's corrected things or not.
Yep.
All right, so there it is. Team Efficiency is on a winning streak. 4 wins and 0 defeats. Is that correct?
Yep, that's right.
Elong is finally back where they need to be. I mean, it looks like the production crew finally corrected the scores. So Elong is at second prize, tied with Team Efficiency. But they did lose one. Well, I mean, that was their disqualification.
Yeah,
it's not really a loss.
Yeah, but they report late, you know, to the Charlotte Tiger, as we said before.
All right, and then we've got Charlotte Tiger. Three wins, 1 defeat. Front Mission's at 2, and 1 defeat. That's putting them at 6 points. And Horseman's at 50-50. They got 2-2, putting them at 6 points. PvP Super Friends, of course, only 1 win. Not quite as Gosu as they used to be, and they've got 4 points as a result. If I'm not mistaken, okay, that's right. They were defeated in one tiebreaker game, so that's where the 1 point comes from. That's why they have 4. All right, Phoenix. 0-3, Coalition Singapore, 0-4. Not looking good this season around.
Yeah, that's right.
We're about halfway through right now with this season 3. So let's dive into the silver. It's, of course, Aces. NVIDIA Aces undefeated at 5-0.
Yeah, but I don't think anyone can win them, you know. Actually, they got a really nice team, but, you know.
It does look like they had to play one tiebreaker game, however, because they have 14 points. If they had 5 wins without a tiebreaker game, then that would mean they would have 15 points. So they had 4 wins and a tiebreaker game victory. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering who it was. We're about to find out.
Yeah,
oh,
but
PvP.
You see the,
PvP Missionary also had a tiebreaker game. Mm. So too did LXG.
Yeah, LOD
and
LXG. So.
All right.
Maybe
okay.
with the Missionary, I guess. You know.
Right.
I mean, NVIDIA.
Right. It's important to note that at the end of this season, the two top teams in the Silver Series will be eligible for a position in the Gold Series, mm-hmm. if I'm not mistaken, for season the next season.
Yep.
Unfortunately, Gash plus Night Eagles, I thought maybe they would be doing a little bit better this time around or this season around, but it just looks like that's not the case. But enough about that. We are just about ready for our game number one almost. All the tanks are loaded up. The first map is going to be... Steps, as you can see, and map two is going to be Himmelsdorf, and I think many people who are watching back at home are thinking, thank God it isn't Prokhorovka, right?
Hmm.
Okay.
Okay, we got Himmelsdorf.
Yeah, yeah. So, map
but
one.
Still step every day.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Alright, so let's go! Alright guys, so it looks like unfortunately this time around we do not have an observer position in game, but we do of course, so that means we're not going to be able to draw on the minimap.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, the tank loadout's going to be T-32 for each side, two MX-1390s for each side, two RU-251s for each side, and two M41 Bulldogs for our left-hand team. I think that's Charlotte Tiger. And of course we've got Phoenix going for that German tank, the Panther, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep. Okay, this time the Phoenix play a different strategy. On previous match, Phoenix team, they always rush to the C1 for whole team. And this time, I feel they want to use a strategy similar to Yilong. Cap first and sniping on the south side.
I think that would be a pretty solid decision to come from them.
Yeah, but you know, the weak part with such strategies, if your enemy know you split to two parts, they cannot rush one side first.
Mm-hmm. I am inclined to believe that. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, look at the way Charlotte Tiger is piled up right now.
Yes.
I mean, let's face it. At this moment, you know, our Japanese juggernauts, they are the favored team here. I mean, what with their third prize win in season two.
Yep.
Nice hit there coming mm-hmm. from Akiov. He's in the M41 Bulldog.
Yeah, but I really wonder if he can go back.
Yeah, one of those things wrecked my AMX-1375.
Oh, no one
this
hit him. Oh, miss.
Okay. At this point.
Oh, the Shaw Tiger, no, they are in the south for sniping, so they are rushed to the south right now.
Oh, man, and that is only half the team of Phoenix. Once they get caught out of position, it could just be, you know, game over from there on out. But we're about to find out. Reno's getting in there. He's in pretty deep already. And the rest of Phoenix is kind of just piling, backpedaling towards the capture point,
mm-hmm.
As well as the rest of their team. I feel like Rodak is doomed almost. He's he's getting chased.
Yeah.
Taking shots.
Can he live there?
That is the question. He's behind a rock.
Whoa,
his track's been hit. He just repaired the track. And for the time being, it looks like he'll be safe, but he took so much damage at that point.
Wow, on this moment, not only him, no.
Fresh
Meat's
one hit.
Yeah, Fresh Meat too.
He is at one shot, and if he's on the reload, that's even worse. I mean, he can't contribute anything in the way of damage to his team.
Mm-hmm.
And Charlotte Tiger behind this, I mean, they've only taken very minimal damage.
Yeah,
It's still a 7v7, but
But they decide to go back. They know they are defense.
Exactly.
They are defensers, so they just go back and wait for you guys coming. And they know you got two guys, only one shot, one kill, so the mess map attack power for the Phoenix, they only have 5 tank and with 2 light tank, right? With 2 tier 7 or 1.
I believe it's 2 tier 7s coming from Charlotte Tiger.
No. One tier 6.
Yeah, they have a VK.
Yeah. VK 2801.
Yeah, there we go. I remember the 2001 has a 105 millimeter cannon, has a nice chunk of damage.
Yeah, but the tank's for defense. No, he's.
Oh yeah, it's got a lousy cannon.
Yeah, yeah.
Because accuracy wise. All right. Well, the capture has been initiated here by Phoenix, and they're forcing the hand of Charlotte Tiger, but they just don't have the HP to hold out, so they have to really, really make an amazing ambush happen here. But Griven's already taking shots. I think that's Plateau that's hitting him. Can't really tell, but it looks like, yeah, I mean, just look at the minimap. Nothing else is, well, almost nothing else was there. Okay. So Griven's out, and there's two one-shot tanks on Phoenix. This is not such a great or fantastic position to be in. But I feel as though if they... I don't know, I mean... What do you think they can do to win at this stage, Edison? I mean, for Team Phoenix.
Well, then right now, you know... actually, the capture circle is not that easy to go back right now. They know the CT... Aki gonna spot anyone, and they can reset a capture really easy. But no, this on the other way, they can ready for sniping. Just trying to force the anyone want to reset a capture, and trying to pull them back and make more damage on that. I mean, you can capture too, but no, set up couple sniper on the back, and when they trying to reset a capture. Trying to take more hit points, as many as possible. But you know, they only have too many, so it's really hard, you know, because of Shark Tiger, they just want to reset capture on last moment. They just go up and reset, go back.
It's
so you cannot do anything there, you know.
They're just bullying their way to victory here in game number one right now.
Yeah,
they know their situation. They know there's two one-shot tanks on Phoenix.
Mm-hmm.
They know that they don't have to go diving into their capture point to get the win, but for Phoenix it's the other way around. They have to either get the kill or get the capture.
Yeah.
So they have to do something soon, because right now they're already surpassed the amount of time it takes for one tank to get the capture and the capture point. Alright. Mm. So where
is it? But you know, Shell Tiger doing really nice on this one because of their reaction. When they got sniping on the south side, they know, okay, you guys split into two parts. So they rush out to the south. Let's charge it. And totally right. You know, they know how to counter such a strategy right now.
Like, everyone is one shot on Phoenix right now. Bingo Bongo just got hit a couple times by Hiwami in that AMX-1390.
Wow.
And now it looks like Charlotte Tiger is kind of moving a little bit across the map. They're going to assert their territory. They've got 1 minute left, and I think their goal right now, aside from getting that capture reset, is also to increase the amount of damage they've output throughout the game.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Hiwami kind of misses there.
Coming.
He's only got a couple shots left before he's on the reload.
Yep. But I'm not sure if he is reloading right now, but I guess maybe no more than two shots he has.
Exactly.
Right, oh, it's reset.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God.
Well, that means Charlotte Tiger can back out, but I don't think it's going to come to that. One more shot left for Hiwami, maybe? If he can hit Bingo Bongo, it'll be a great spot. And he's not even trying to hit Nisa there. Yeah, well, Charlotte Tiger says, you want to push or not, we're going to push it to you.
Mm-hmm.
Nisa's getting totally flanked there. It wasn't a free fight. Hiwami did fall. And, I mean, a 7-for-1 exchange, well, let's be real here. It's not gonna get you the win in a tournament. That's a nice bounce, but Nisa... No, he doesn't get it. All right. So Blade is the last tank on the battlefield. He's screaming, no!
Yeah, but I think, you know, Shanghai is doing really nice here, you know. I think I have to say that Phoenix, they also trying to play on different strategy, you know, somewhat like Elon's type, but on that way, you have to also understand about if you such strategy, your enemy, how to counter that. On such scenario, how do you react about the counter strategy, you know?
I mean... Yeah, that's basically, how do I say this? We have to stop and examine what happened in this game from start to finish. Right off the bat, we saw two tanks from Phoenix go to one-shot status.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you're going to go straight into that, it's not a good way to start off a round. Hiwami did take a little bit of damage there in the beginning, if I'm not mistaken, but it wasn't anything near the perhaps 1800 that was dealt out on those two tanks. Mm-hmm. And that just kept them out of the fight the entire game. They couldn't go on the prowl. They couldn't do scouting. So any push that they were going to do was going to be very conservative. And it just looked like everything that Charlotte Tiger wanted to do was counterplayed. Mm-hmm. Or everything that Phoenix wanted to do was counterplayed by Charlotte Tiger. Excuse me.
Okay.
All right. Mm-hmm. So...
Yep.
And we are back here with round number two on offense for Team Phoenix once again. And mm-hmm. hopefully they can pick up the slack where things kind of fell off in the last game. And sorry about that very brief and unprecedented break that we got. looks like our production crew misunderstood what we were saying mm-hmm. up here on stage. But for the time being, we've got game number two just about ready to start. Everyone's loaded up with okay. their tanks.
Yeah, I think on the Phoenix side, they have sent loadout, right?
I believe so. Let's check things out from...
T32,
M13... VK2801. So yeah. wait a minute. There was actually that... Phoenix has a T49 this time. Last game they actually had the German one that Horseman was using. Do you remember? Tier 6 tank. So this time we've got Phoenix using 686, I think. Last game they didn't have a T49, did they?
Someone had T49, but I don't remember it's a Phoenix or... Shadow Tiger, but on the past experience, the Shadow Tiger really love to use a T49.
Absolutely.
Oh, no. Shadow Tiger
Phoenix
is totally the same, so I said Phoenix.
My mistake, okay.
Yeah. Shadow Tiger is the same, they got two Bulldogs.
All right, then that's my mistake. I actually read it the wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Wrong side.
mm-hmm. So, spawning to the south, it's going to be Team Phoenix. They are on offense, and to the north, it's going to be Charlotte Tiger. Stopping to think here about just where things might go here in the near future. I mean, with this one game. But for the time being, it looks like we've got an RU251 accompanying Griffin to go to the capture point one. And Phoenix has some kind of a trick up their sleeves. They've got the T32 just cruising up the center of the map. I kind of like that idea, just a little bit. The road is basically safe from any sniping, for the most part. But just what the plan is from Phoenix is not entirely clear to me just yet. What do you think, Edison?
Right now, I think they still want to use the capture strategy, but this time, I think they're going to be more cautious about that. You know, do you see that on the south part?
Yeah.
They take more far distance sniping strategy. So if a shot tag come here, they're gonna run here on this side.
All right. So
they won't get any penalty about that. You know?
Okay. I think I see now. I mean, the T32 that we have from Phoenix is going to be the worm on the hook, and those three tanks at the south end of the map are those few tanks at the south end of the map are going to be. Fishermen. Very, very hungry fishermen. All right. Griven's just going to poke around the map. I think he's just going to make sure the capture point is safe before hopping in there. And there's blind fire coming from Phoenix. Blind fire coming from Charlotte Tiger. trying to hit whatever
NISA,
it may be there.
No, they're trying to use a NISA to use a 50-meter rule to spot the it's Aki, right? Oh, yeah.
I think so, yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, let's see how this works out. Capture's initiated, no reset yet.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's only one push, but I don't know why on the screen I cannot see the push on the capture circle. BK 2801, they kept on the north side, and the bush is on the middle. So they flash shot the middle bush, but then they said a capture. The Aki have to spot him right now.
Oh, here we are.
Do you got it?
Maybe. I mean, there's 20 seconds.
No bubble. No bubble.
Nothing whatsoever. No light bulb?
Yeah.
Oh. The light bulb mod is broken, but I think everyone knows that. Okay. I think everyone knows he's hiding behind that bush.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
But
so.
No, here is a tree, not a bush. So he pulled down the tree, so it become another camo. But the bush is on the middle.
Okay.
Yeah, I drew on the minimap. All
right. The thing is, I think everyone knows he's right there,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, there is a little bush, right?
Yeah.
And here is a tree.
Akio, blind fire. Was that a blind fire?
No, I don't think
Oh, man, Griffin is so hit right now. He's one shot.
Yeah, he's spotted.
Yeah, he's down to 17 HP at this very moment. He takes a hit anywhere on his tank, and he's essentially done for. Okay, so...
Oh.
I mean, that was...
The Aki sacrifice. He come in, so he saw the Griffin there. But, you know, he's died there.
The rest of Charlotte Tiger, I think they've got an idea of just where NISA is right now. The question is, like, what's their plan going to be? They're still trying to hit Griven, and Griven's finally safely behind.
Yeah, but I bet the Griven is going to capture again.
Maybe. I mean, that sounds like...
Yeah, choose the other bush right now,
boy.
But...
Here we go. It's been initiated.
Yeah, but, you know, it's still risky.
Turning his rear there.
Yeah, but you know, he was spotted. If he was spotted, he's still gonna be shot.
Blind fire coming so close. Mm-hmm. Alright, more blind fire. And if he gets taken out, I don't know. But here comes a huge flank on the eastern side of the minimap, as you guys can see.
Yeah.
And I like this move from Phoenix. This could actually get them the win.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see how this pans out.
Yeah, Nisa gonna push too. When they rush in, Nisa gonna push. So. This time, I think the Phoenix doing really nice and really well prepared. And I just thinking about if the NISA can cap two.
Yeah, two capture points are being taken at the same time. The question is, how does Phoenix coordinate themselves? They've got their RU251s now rushing to the section of the map where Charlotte Tiger is engaging Phoenix. And the question to be asked then is, will Plateau and Lobos Tomy be able to stop them before it happens?
Yeah, and NISA and Blade on the North Park. Can they stop the reset of the Shark Tiger?
This exchange of fire is far more in favor of Phoenix than it is for Charlotte Tiger.
Yeah,
as you can see,
yeah.
There's already three tanks falling for them. We've got Lobos Tomy down to 228.
Really nice to win right now.
Plateau is at 405 HP, and Hiwami is down to 799. Polly is being chased down right now.
Yeah, but I think someone needs to capture.
Hiwami.
I don't know why the VK2801 leave the capture circle, because there is no enemy.
This is brilliant. I mean, like, oh man, right
now
I feel.
Why he leave the capture?
There's more than enough time, surely, Edison. There's more than enough time once they take down.
He was done. Someone kill him.
I think what they're doing is they're doing guerrilla tanking, if you will. They're just gonna try and pop one or two shots out, then run for the hills, try and keep the capture reset for as long as possible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But both capture points, no, I'm sorry, only one capture point
one.
Is being captured
yeah.
on right now.
Yeah.
That T-32 has to be knocked out for Phoenix to stand any shot of this working
Oh,
out.
He missing! Wow.
And Rodak...
So critical, you know, if he missed that, he cannot kill him on this shot.
Plateau
maybe gonna...
is not turning around,
yeah,
he doesn't want to fight
he
back.
He cannot let the T-32 up, or they're gonna lose this one. Oh, he bounced!
No!
My god!
There's a bounce,
what's
he's getting
going
up the hill! 30 seconds remaining, 13 seconds on the capture. 11,
okay.
10 seconds.
9, 8, Seven.
Oh man, this is a game that goes straight
they
to Phoenix.
They got this one. They got this one.
Yeah.
Nice.
Unless there's a bug with the mod and we're seeing this completely differently. I mean, let's count 5.
Yeah, whatever.
4, 3,
they
2,
should win.
1, 0.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay.
All right,
nice,
all right.
Nice,
with
nice.
5 seconds left on the clock, we see Phoenix get a win via capture. That was not bad. I mean, so now it's going to switch around.
But I feel this one is really nice. Yeah. Really, really nice. But first of all, they have to kill the Aki first. They're trying to, you know, attract Aki out and kill him. After he kill him, they can try to cap again. Or, you know, enemy's attention will all put on the north. And at the moment, they go to the south and flanking really nice.
Beautiful. It was amazing.
Yeah, it's beautiful. It was.
But I mean, like, I also want to point out that, what was it? The VK2801 was taken down to 17 HP in exchange for taking down one tank on Charlotte Tiger. Once that tank was no longer there, we basically had the win set up and in order for what's what I'm looking for Phoenix. I guess you could say that's not, it's kind of the domino effect. Not really, you know, the ace in the hole. Not really what won them the game, but definitely what put them on fighting grounds with Charlotte Tiger. Mm-hmm. And that capture was simply a distraction. It was amazing. It was, I mean, the way it was executed, everything.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, now we switch things around. Phoenix is going to go on defense while we have Charlotte Tiger on the offensive. So don't go away, guys. Let's stick around for round number 3. All right, guys, we are back now with round number 3, and let's not forget that's going to put Phoenix on defense with, I guess you could say, kind of a slight advantage here. I mean, typically, defensive rounds on maps are more easy, but that's typically on a map where, well, it's been played in the meta time and again, like Himmelsdorf.
Yep, but, you know, Mainz, on this one, it's more dependent on the personal skill of light tank, because of I have to say, normally people do not love the light hand on this game.
Yeah.
Because it's not that easy to control, but, you know, for the tournament play, they have to be familiar with that. So sometimes, like Yilong team, they training every day. They know, most of Yilong team, if you meet them, you're going to see they, a lot of players play the M1390. So that's why when they, on the Pokanovka, they use a lot of the 1390, you know, compared to other team.
Absolutely, and I mean, like, it kind of seems like a nice break to actually see map number 2 on Himmelsdorf as opposed to Prokhorovka. But I'm a little bit curious to see how things are going to turn out on this map. But for the time being, we're still waiting for two tanks to finish their selection, and then we should be able to pop into the game.
Yeah, but, you know, Finland's team, they choose two
Centurions.
One, you know, is a tier A mid tank, something like a Persian, but, you know, the gun. And the DPM is a little, slightly better, but the tank is not that fast. So when you're trying to move somewhere, you know, quite slow, like a heavy tank.
Do you think that means they'll sit and spawn when the game begins? I mean, spawn is basically, the spawn point is basically close to both capture point 1 and capture point 2. Do you think that's their plan? Or I don't see, you know, if you're on defense, putting one of those Centurions at capture point 1 and putting the other at capture point 2 is not that great of an idea, especially when your other team is going to be mostly light tanks. But an M44 SPG is coming out of...
But no, M44 on the defense team, that means they can...
Force the enemy team to rush.
No.
No?
They're going to use that to reset a capture.
They're
going to take the safest way. to reset a capture point.
All right. Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right. Okay, I forgot. Mm-hmm. Like most of the time, whenever
because
we see,
you know, because of that, on that moment, we saw more and more team they know how to use push, right? So even so, when you go up with the binocular, you cannot see everything on the capture circle except the tank behind the bush. So when they go up, they try to spot and see nothing, they're gonna pull back. They don't want to take the risk to go too far away and shoot in the capture circle, blind shot the capture circle, you know. So they want to use the SPG to reset capture.
There's our handsome SPG at this very moment.
Yeah, but once you use the SPG, that means you lose the firepower of Tier 6. So,
I mean, it can be pretty weak. I mean, I've asked previously other players how much damage they do with that SPG with the M44, and one, I believe it was Death's Guys who told me, he said not more than, I didn't do, no, I'm sorry, it was Comics.
It's a Comics.
Yeah, he told me not more than 400.
Yeah, and it only get one shot is 400, I think.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Only one shot is 400?
One shot, yeah, but, you know, on a hammer stuff, it's not that easy because of when you use the SPG, your enemy, normally they want to rush, but 2 days ago, the Horseman versus the Team Yilong, the Yilong team, the Yilong used the SPG, that's an M44, but the Horseman still stand there. And after the whole game, whole match, I think the M44 only making less than 400 damage, less than 400.
I mean, yeah, I remember that. But at the same time, that SPG knew 100% where one of the tanks would be on Himmelsdorf, and of course they were trying to exploit that as much as they could. Getting that one IS-3 behind the behind the spawn window is a must-have.
I just saw you guys use the M44. They know you share the firepower on Tier 6. So this time they want to push directly from the south side. You know, that's a hard fight on the south. You know, they're gonna use IS-3, you know, show up torrent, and they're gonna push as soon as possible so they know you are short of one tank there.
All right, so here's the move being made at the very moment.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing but lights coming from Charlotte Tiger. They're ready to pile in there.
Yeah, it already could bear.
Was that a shot from a T-49 or an SPG just now? Both are slow moving.
I'm not sure, but you know, if you cannot see a track. You cannot see a trace on the mod right now.
Rodak is in a nice position there, getting some good flanking fire.
Yeah.
And right now, all of Charlotte Tiger is piled up in one location. This can work against them or it can work for them. Bingo Bongo's trying to make his shots hit as best he can. Plateau fell in the background with that rush. 746 HP remaining on Reno.
Mm-hmm.
481 now. 509 on Akiov. And it looks like in the background, we had Nisa
first
taken down.
Fresh meat only got a little hit point, but no one shoot him.
Indeed. And now, beyond that, I mean, we see everyone's falling left and right. Iwami is Ultra 1 hit in that present location. Mishima, 93. Does get the finishing blow on 2.
Yeah.
Fresh meat.
Wow.
Phoenix Blade is going to try and chase down Polly. I believe Polly's on the reload.
Yeah, but Blake's going to die too, I think. Oh, he's bounced.
Oh, that was a nice bounce from Reno.
Different. What's going on there?
CT Reno is trying to make his shots count as best he can, and Rodak is going to try and flank him. Right now, it's only two members of Charlotte Tiger versus the three of Phoenix.
Yeah, they're going to be one.
RU251 versus RU251 in this present location. Reno is running straight into his demise. Polly is the last tanker alive. I believe he's reloaded now because I also do be fighting face to face. Track shotted as well.
It spawns.
Yes, Sponster. Bingo Bongo, Sponster.
But autoloader is coming.
Rodak.
Yeah. What? Missing.
It's almost over. It's all but over. Polly's running for his dear
missing
life.
Missing again.
He's on the reload after one more shot, and there he goes.
Okay.
All right, so 3 minutes was remaining on the clock, and it looks like Charlotte Tiger, I mean, they got pushed into that, and it didn't quite work out in the end, but, I mean, that's more power to Phoenix. They found these guys' Achilles heel. We see Phoenix in a position that we don't see many teams in. They are up 1 point over Charlotte Tiger.
Yeah, but no, I think Charlotte Tiger, you know, I have to say that, you know, I feel when Charlotte Tiger see the M44, they change their strategy, you know, The strategy is not they normally use. Normally go to the North Pine, use I3, show up torrent and push step by step slowly. But they know if they do that, the SPG gonna keep shooting him. But actually, SPG's hit ratio is really low. So it's not that they cannot, the SPG cannot make real damage, but they gonna give you a pressure.
That, right. You know, it changes the meta. It's like, mm-hmm. okay, so you guys are going to have to come at us. We cannot, I mean, we can sit here all day, mm-hmm. but you guys can't stay over there. Otherwise, we're going to have just free shots to unload on you.
Yeah, so when they see that, they should think, okay, you got SPG, we can push. But they choose the wrong way. Why I say that? Because of everyone go to a lower power without any cover. They saw a M13 on the east, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they saw someone on the low power and someone on the high ground, so they still, you know, keep moving directly and become a, you know, everyone circle around you.
I also want to add to that Rodak, he was at a very brilliant position, mm-hmm. At that hill that was at the very, very northernmost part of the map. It was about, I can't say, maybe the A8 quadrant, maybe A7, A6. Very close to spawn, and when Charlotte Tiger was just rushing in there,
mm-hmm.
he was getting a bunch of shots, and Charlotte Tiger wasn't even looking at him. To the effect that he was able to come back later on with almost full HP mm-hmm. and get that the second to the last tank at the very last moment. I mean, it's just brilliant flanking positioning, and I feel like maybe something was missing from Charlotte Tiger's scouting skills just a little bit.
Not only scouting, because if like you go to a lower part, normally it's really hard to counter the higher ground, because mm-hmm. when a tank on the high ground, they shoot you, they can pull back and hide.
Exactly.
But if you're on the lower ground, you cannot do anything. You only can wait in for them shooting on you, and you can counter on that way. But if they flank it, you don't know that, because you cannot see anyone there. That's why I always say, the higher ground is much better for defense or assault, a better route than on the lower ground, you know. Yep.
I mean, as said before, we now see Phoenix in a position that we don't see many teams in the WGL APAC Asia have the right to say, and that is we're up 1 point versus mm-hmm. Charlotte Tiger.
Yep.
The question is it going to be smooth or not? We're about to find out after a quick 90-second commercial break. Don't go away, guys. All right, guys, we are back now with what is effectively speaking the final map, or excuse me, the final round of steps. Yeah, mm-hmm. map one steps. So the question is, are we going to see an even 2-2 at the end of this map, or are we going to see it taken into 3-1 from Phoenix? I mean, they've certainly overhauled their gameplay how do I say this? I mean, like, they've kind of had some bumpy mm-hmm. performance, not absolutely perfect. Like, what was the last team that they beat? Can you remember? Was it PvP Super Friends? Maybe. Mm. Have they played PvP yet?
You mean Shot Tiger or Team Efficiency?
I mean to say Phoenix. Which team have they played against?
Last
PvP?
One, they... Mercy.
Was Elong?
Elong and a percent? Oh, no. you know, they rush whole game, you know, five match, yeah. all rush, and you know, every game, every match only taking like 2 minutes and over.
Right. Mm-hmm. All right. So, Nisa, I mean, basically, we've got Team Phoenix saying, okay, if it's not broke, don't fix it. We're going to do the same thing all over again. And they have the SPG there all over again. I think maybe this time with the rush, Charlotte Tiger will be a little bit more cautious to check all corners of the map, or maybe just make their rush a little bit more refined, if you will. Just go in there straight up without missing. Maybe not so much focused on the artillery,
yeah,
but focused on the tanks that matter.
This time they go to the high ground. Go to the high ground, I think that's right.
And they are so exposed in that position.
Yep, yep. But you know, this time a sniper on the road deck cannot shoot anyone there.
That is right. I mean, Rodak, his position is kind of like null.
Yeah,
but wait,
you know,
they're over the hill
the
now.
Finnish team, they still, not Finnish team, the Shell Tiger, they still focus on the mid tank first. Maybe they should focus on the high tank first.
He's out, Akiyov is out, Griffin is out, and the rest of Phoenix is out. It looks like this tactic is working quite well. Rodak is showing up just a little bit too late to the party. Right now it's 5 versus 3, including him just now showing up.
But Rodak do not have ammo, I think. He is on the reloading, or he almost on the reloading right now. I have to say that.
Well, here we are. Nisa's going to try and make that arty count as much as possible. Didn't quite make
it. Yeah, they don't want to shoot arty right now, you know, because the arty only offer quite low DPM, quite low damage. It's not, you know.
This time,
as I say, you know, they go through the higher ground. That's it. You don't have to, you know, get a lot of a fire from every side. You just go to a high ground, kill someone first. That's it.
I mean, like, that's this set. That's this series in a nutshell. I mean, it comes 2-2, and this is, again, like what I was talking about day before yesterday, the Yomi effect. Okay, you guys did this game number one. We're going to do this game number two. They each won one on attacking and one on defense. So, I mean, well, how do I say this? Both sides won one game on attack. Both sides won one game on defense. They're like, okay, you guys like to do this. We'll do this instead. And it works.
Yeah.
Just like that. With more than just, I guess you could say, your all-star teams. But something to think about as we go into map number two on Himmelsdorf is, how is this going to pan out? It's one of those more... it's one of the most played maps, honestly. Did we see a single set in Season 2 without... Himmelsdorf? Did we go a day without watching a game on Himmelsdorf?
No, never. Yeah.
So, I mean...
Because Himmelsdorf is a quite fair map. Mm-hmm. It's somewhat camping, but, you know, it's not that benefit for camping side, you know, before, but, you know, this time.
Yeah.
We got 7 tanks camping together. It's somewhat hard to attack. It's really hard, but, you know, after a couple of teams use a KV-4 or KV-5, it's working and can go through quite easy. Not easy, you know, can break through, but I don't think it's really, really camping map, you know.
You've got
a lot of strategy to break through.
And last time we saw Charlotte Tiger play on this map, that was Elong.
Elong.
I mean, Elong, they're the all-star team in, in APAC. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're... If you can beat Elong in a single day, you're doing great. But at the same time, they pioneered new strategies. I want to see if Charlotte Tiger has anything new up their sleeves. Neither side has selected their tanks yet. Neither side has even begun. That's because we need to take things into a quick break. And then we'll be back in about 3 minutes with...
Three,
maybe? Five?
Maybe because they're going to change map. So maybe 7 minutes something.
Well, shucks. We'll be back in a few minutes.
Okay.
With game number one.
Okay. Huh? Something?
Okay, guys, we are back now. Game number one, of course, is going to be on Himmelsdorf. On defense, it's going to be...
Let me check it. I'm on the... That's Phoenix.
Phoenix. Okay, okay. I find that a little bit interesting because we saw Phoenix attacking in game number one, or map number one, right? We saw them on offensive in map number one.
But, you know, I'm not sure about rule right now because I'm not a tournament player for a long time, so... okay.
Alright, alright. I mean, that makes sense.
To reply your question, because if a team choose a map, normally a team, we got only two maps, right? So
right.
Each team got a one right to choose a map, and they got one right to choose defense or assault.
All right, that makes more sense. Okay, so we are now getting this game underway. Pretty standard defensive setup coming from Charlotte Tiger, but there's a, from Phoenix, but there's a new twist to it. They're sending a VK 2801 across the map, and I'm not entirely sure what their idea with that is. Of course, it's light tanks, of course, they're not meant to do damage, they're meant to do scouting.
Yeah, but you know, if he focus on the MS-50, he can make a lot of damage there, you know, but if he infests the I-3, you know, he cannot penetrate that.
Alright, so... Here we are, Griven. Oh. He's about to spot these guys. Mm-hmm. Hello.
Yeah, but you know, normally on the defense side, they love to. Not they, you know, most of the tournament team here on the C server, the HR server, they choose two tier 7 heavy tank because of the firepower is much bigger than the A6 combination.
That's true. I mean, the most frequent trend that we've seen is basically tier 7 IS being taken. And
Tiger.
Tiger?
Yeah, Tiger.
Yeah, that
one. T29.
Firepower, of course. Mm-hmm. T29's, of course, the very bouncy turret hole. I mean, the AMX M445 I've used shooting at a T29.
Oh,
it's a pain in the rear.
No. Missed shots.
Ooh, second one hits for pretty much more than half.
Yeah, they missed two, but, you know, the third one and the second one. Because the average damage about the I3 is 390. So, you know, it making... Less than 400 is not many.
Okay. I like penguins. Very random reference. I know we got nothing to talk about, but I mean, I just thought I'd mention that. Anyway. So we can see, basically, Phoenix is forced to sit on their hands just a little bit right here in this present position. I like the choice to put the T32 in the window, of course. That is very, very standard. And Chinese 110 about to turn that corner.
Okay, they're gonna use two defender here. Someone trying to capture, and this one is real capture, I think. The M6, they're gonna use the M6 combination with I3 capture again, and they use I3 on the middle to defend, and the south side is M50 in order to prevent the flanking.
Basically, the meat shield is gonna come out, and I think it's gonna be Reno here.
Yeah, but you know. Because of this side, I mean, Venice, they already know someone is standing here, so maybe they can stick together one way, push through, you know, might be better because of M50 may not be on time.
There we go, they're piling in. Plateau is turning to an angle. I think he's meant to die here, maybe. Maybe not? Oh, there we go. Yeah, he's gonna die, and he's gonna shield Hiwami there. Brilliant. I mean, it's not the first time we've seen this done before. We've seen a dead aim. We've seen a dead M6 there before, shielding Batman's AMX
1390. Yeah, but you know, they should use other tank except the I3. You know, normally the Elong team or team efficiency, they're gonna choose a KV4, choose KV4 for capturing.
All right. So I mean, the clock is ticking right now.
Mm-hmm.
And at this moment, Phoenix, they gotta do something about this. So far, I mean, the amount of damage dealt out on them is Dantral, although a good chunk of it's been done to Griven. Wow, not so much a DPS tank, more of a scouting tank.
Spunkster, you know, he's standing with a really nice position because Fennec's team are so reliable to kill him right now.
All right, so there's Iwami. Of course, he did get hit just a minute ago. The reset happened. I think if it didn't come from Griven, it came from Nissa. I think Griven's about to turn that corner and maybe take a shot, but our observer didn't catch that previously. So if we see Griven, just turn that corner, take the shot, there's a chance that Iwami might fire back. And wait.
Oh, he's bounced.
Iwami is actually ready to shoot Griven. Okay, so Griven did get the reset earlier, but he's gonna have to make another shot that does reset at some point or another, at least to disable a single tank capture.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Shaw Tiger got really low hit points.
Mm-hmm.
But no, not that different because of it's separate two parts. And the Phoenix also separate two, so they don't have the firepower to break through right now.
This is getting to that chaotic point in the game where Phoenix is probably going to snap, dive in, hope they can kill more tanks, and then get Griven to hide.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
Wait, Griven, he's just about to turn that corner.
No, why he gets the reset?
He got the reset. It doesn't matter, Edison.
He run, and he shoot, and he got a reset.
Rambo!
Wow.
Rambo tank.
Oh my god.
Yeah. VK2801, and it looks like he's going to turn the corner again and maybe try and get another shot on Iwami. He waited for his vision to get reset, and now Charlotte Tiger is falling just a little bit one by one. Iwami looks like he might get hit again. No?
Oh!
Okay. Oh, wow, man, Nissa took him down. So capturing at this point is going to be extremely difficult, to say the very least. Unviable at this moment. Polly is going up against Rodak and Fresh Meat, and now Spawnster as well. He's one shot,
wow,
and I think Fresh Meat takes him out of that game. Akiolf just behind. Our three tanks are now... He's the last one in the game. Once he gets taken down, the game's over, and I think Phoenix is going to waste no time doing that. Remember, if in the case that we see a draw scenario come together, the team that has the least offensive time will get to choose offense or defense.
Yeah,
that's a nice bounce. Yep. Like, this guy's bouncing like crazy.
But you know, it seems the defense are gonna win. We won't count on this one.
Maybe.
Sure. Not maybe.
I mean, we've seen innovative strategies from Charlotte Tiger before.
I mean, this one not count for the tiebreaker. On the tiebreaker.
You think there will be a tiebreaker?
No.
No? Oh, boy.
I feel the Phoenix is going to win this one.
I think you're right. I mean, right now the score is 3-2. They only have to win two more games to actually win the night out, and that would be considered a bit of an upset. Actually, a lot less than a bit of an upset, because we're talking about Charlotte Tiger went to the Season 2 Grand Finals. We saw them playing at the OGN studio in Korea. Mm-hmm. They gave us the clean source. We were streaming it in English. I was here to watch, and I loved it from start to finish.
Yeah, but, you know, today, Phoenix today, they give us a new Phoenix, you know.
They did. They are finally,
really nice.
They're finally the reborn bird from the ashes of the old one that they were.
Okay, like a legend, reborn from the fire.
Indeed, indeed. Okay, so guys, we're going to go into round number 2 on defense for Charlotte Tiger here in a quick moment. We'll be back in about 90 seconds. Mm-hmm. Thank you. All right, guys, we are back now with round number two on defense for Phoenix. They're up 1 point in this match. But again, we've seen the Yomi effect work time and again.
Yep.
I think what Charlotte Tiger is going to... I think what Charlotte Tiger was doing at the break was thinking, okay, well, that's what they did. This is the mistakes we made. Okay, so we're not going to do that this game. We're going to do something completely different. And what do you think it's going to be?
But this time, why they win? Because of like doing really nice on reaction.
Oh,
they
yeah.
They know you only have one capture. The other ones die. They're going to use a M6 because of it's a big fat tier 6. You know, we call it bake. But, you know, it's too fast, so it's really nice for cover. Mm-hmm. But they know you only have I3 for capture. So the capture is not that emergency, you know. They got 100 seconds to reload one, reset once. That's it. So they have a time to relocation, to go to the south, go to the hillside, to reset. That's it.
And initially, I want to point out that they had five... I'm not sure if those were five tier 8 tanks altogether, but there were initially five tanks that were doing the push up the... let me see here, the A5 and the A6 or A7 lines there. And I can't remember if one of those tanks that was pushing with them was the one that died and was acting as the meat shield, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, like, I feel as though they were setting up an ambush quite well. I think they were banking on Phoenix just rushing in there, and the rush just never happened. Do you think so, or...?
Yeah, they're waiting for their rush, but on the other part, they are waiting for their flanking. But actually, if they rush directly through the north, I think the Phoenix team still win because of the M50 on the south side. Then I don't think they are ready for go to the best on that moment. If they rush together, I mean the Phoenix team, if rush together, they can win the Shadow Tiger, I think.
All right, so here we go. The game has changed just a little bit. Four IS-3s, two AMX-50s, and SPG.
Yeah.
F304 coming from Charlotte Tiger.
Yep.
Chinese 110, two AMX-50s, two IS-3s, two T-32s, and a VK-2801 coming from Phoenix. Now, what Charlotte Tiger is saying is, we don't want you guys camping this game around, and I think there's a part of Phoenix that says, okay, we won't camp.
Mm-hmm.
Because you guys can see it as plain as day. It looks like, for the most part, yeah, the T-32 is breaking away from the team. I don't understand this decision.
Mm.
Edison, why? If you look at the minimap.
I don't know. But actually, if they rush to the south and face to the enemy, they're gonna have some problem about that because they are short of gear A.
Alright.
You think so?
Well, let me see here. At this present moment, I mean, the VK-28 is doing... I mean, this is basically the best scout... or the best scouting tank
I've
seen in a while.
Oh, they got the VK-2801 right now.
And he's cornered. Bingo Bongo is going to try and turn the corner and maybe give him some support.
He missed it. And he got a...
Exchange of fire. Bingo Bongo takes damage.
Bingo Bongo
Reno does not.
He's missing too.
Yeah, Reno and Akio both leave that scratchless, essentially.
T-32 is coming.
Yeah. And we can see the big flank, the big pile-in, I guess you could say. Mm-hmm. But we're still waiting for that T-32, as Edison said. It's only halfway across the map. Is it hiding behind the fountain? I mean, it's got that strong turret, just like a T-29.
Yep.
It's a pain in the rear to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
And he's playing the sniping game, is he?
Yep.
Can't quite see him in the observer's window.
He only can shoot the M50, but on this moment, if a shot tiger knows, okay, we got someone on the square garden, we're gonna push directly.
All right, so...
The damage is quite even right now. Whoa, it's bounced.
Wait a minute. If four tanks pile in on this position, Sponster and Blade are not going to be too terribly hot in performance. Look at this.
They're taking
a good chunk of damage. We can't see Sponster's total HP right now, but he is out of the game just as I say that. And Blade is getting lit up by three angry tanks coming from Charlotte Tiger. It looks as though their meta has been... I wouldn't say necessarily figured out. But that positioning from the VK-2801 is meant to intercept the SPG coming from CT.
Yeah, but you know, I have to say the Shadow Tiger's personal skill is much better than Trainer's.
Absolutely.
They are 3v3, but you know, the two is dying.
Alright, so Bingo Bongo and Griven going toe-to-toe with that Reno, but Reno gets the finishing blow on.
Oh, nice.
I believe that was Rodak.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's Griven going yellow swag against all these guys.
Wow.
Doesn't quite work out in the end. Iwami does get the finishing blow onto him. Phoenix, mm-hmm. Fresh Meat, mm-hmm. and Nisa are still alive.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like with 4 minutes on the clock, it's...
Yeah, he can't keep going.
Right. I don't want to say it's impossible, but I have never seen a single tank win against six tanks with only 4 minutes on the clock.
Yeah, he's knife.
Right, right, right. This isn't, you know, this isn't make the plays happen. This is World of Team.
Okay. Three versus three right now.
Yeah. 3-3.
Tiebreaker?
Maybe.
But
that's one. Like I said, every time we see them go on attack, every time we see them go on defense.
Yeah, but, you
there
know,
it is.
On the personal skill, I'm talking about non strategy, only personal skill.
Charlotte Tiger wins.
Really
always.
Much better.
Right.
But, you know, this time.
To the extent.
If they only. They just camp on there, and the Finnish team didn't create too many new stuff there, you know. I mean, if they have to, you know, go through directly, the win rate of the Finnish is quite low. But, you know, today they got a lot of new stuff we already seen, right?
Right.
So maybe they're going to have to give us a new strategy here.
I know. I mean, a lot of you guys might think, okay, well, I mean, these guys, they don't look like they're practicing full-time. But if you're just a commander and you're thinking of strategies to employ, that in and of itself is a full-time job. You got to go looking at VODs. Mm-hmm. You got to go look at other regions' play styles. You got to go ahead and take the meta and try and make it yours on your own server, that kind of thing. But, I mean, as you said it before, the personal skill of Charlotte Tiger, tank per tank, is much, much better than it is for Phoenix. And I don't want to say Phoenix is getting lucky. It couldn't be further from the truth to say that they're getting lucky. They're outwitting their opponents in many ways. And the score is now 3-3. So far we've seen for every two intervals of attack and two intervals of defense, we've seen each team win one game and each team lose one game. The Yomi effect at play.
Yep.
And I think it's with the next two games that we find out whether or not we're going to have a tiebreaker. So don't go away. We'll be back in about 90 seconds, guys. All right, guys, we're back with more Tonks action as we hop into Charlotte Tiger going on the defensive while we have Phoenix going on the offensive. Now, the trend that we've seen, I mean, the real highlight for all the matches that we've seen tonight is that, okay, if you guys want to force your opponent to rush out to you, just grab an artillery.
Yeah.
I mean, that seems to be the highlight of tonight's match.
Yeah, totally right. You know, we saw that on the hemp stove. I saw that on the step. If you don't move, you know, you might got a problem, but except one scenario, you know. If your enemy is a Team Yilong, maybe you're going to consider about that.
Oh, yeah. And I mean, there's one thing I liked about that game coming from Phoenix that Charlotte Tiger was kind of stopped from doing just a little bit. There's this one spot on the south part of the map where an artillery can go, and it can hit the position where a T-32 would be camping at capture point 2, or basically near the spawn point of the defending team.
Yeah, and do you know, when the artillery only have tier A, you know, I mean, the Tier 8 is actually better than Tier 10 right now.
Really?
So, yeah. You know, a lot of tanks really suit her. I mean, the artillery is really nice. But on that day, Tier 8 came on the steps or whatever. A lot of maps, like, every team choose one Tier 8 artillery or Tier 7 artillery. And even they choose that, another team won't rush because of the artillery's power is really high. Actually, it's a Tier 11 tank, you know.
All right. Mm-hmm. Well, the only big difference or the big tank that really stands out the most that I saw at the beginning of this game was a KV-3 coming from Charlotte Tiger.
Mm-hmm.
But even so, it looks like they're going for the standard defensive setup. Phoenix Griven is going to go ahead and poke out a little bit more of this VK-2801. And I feel like this game, we see Phoenix doing something that isn't typically done all that much. They're trying to capitalize on getting a capture at capture point one, I think.
Yep.
And I think they're going to use the meat shield tank. That's basically when they kill their own tank to use it as a roadblock for another tank that's trying to capture.
Yeah, possible. But before they do that, I feel they want to use the VK-2801 to spot the T-29 there.
Griven hops in. He gives away his position. I think he got track shot just a little bit. Like, tracks have been hit, but not really damaged. Something that frequently happens, at least in random battles.
Yeah, but still really dangerous because the T-32 is here. So if he capture, he's going to get two-sided shot. He's got more chance to reset a capture.
All right. So there it is. Opalus is going to try and poke down just a little bit. I mean, with this, I'm not entirely sure what Griven's doing there in the VK-2801. He can't offer too much firepower. He can't offer too much shield.
Yeah, the only way is spot and capture.
You know what I think he's going to do?
Uh-huh.
He's the smallest tank on his team, right?
Yep.
I think what they're going to do is maybe move up with one of the other tanks from Phoenix, and then he's going to get behind that tank. Maybe?
No. Actually, he's not that small. Do you see I3 compared to VK-2801? It's somewhat similar size.
Right, it's a little bit taller.
Yeah, it's a big, like a high tank. If they, if you want to hide some behind someone, they should use the 1280T. Might be the smallest.
So here we are again. Blade and Nisa trying to play their picks. They're getting the shorter end of the stick on this one. And thus far, to Charlotte Tiger's name, only one tank has taken damage, and that's Hiwami now with 1,103 HP remaining. Griven takes a huge chunk there.
Yeah,
that is
300, I think.
He's only got 318 left out of his 800. I'm sorry, out of his 610, it looks like.
Yep.
That's almost 50%. Almost.
Yeah, but it's a normal damage on the T-32.
Yeah.
Yeah, not too many, it's quite standard.
That is the crazy part about it. Okay, so. Nisa again, just playing those pokes, I guess you could say.
Yeah, but do you remember Team Elon on the Tuesday? They line up here.
Oh, yeah. That was Horseman.
Yeah, Horseman. Here.
They had the KV-5 at the very front of it, and it acted very effectively as a meat shield and stayed alive all throughout the game.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's quite interesting, and Elon put one tank in. I do remember that. It's quite different strategy, so every time we've seen a new strategy, we have to think about why they're doing that. What's the reason to that? Maybe it's much better to cover two bases or something.
Opalisk is taking a lot of damage there. That looks a lot like a T-29's turret. What on earth is he piloting?
Oh!
He's in...
By the commander tower? Yeah.
That is a T-29. It's Tier 7, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Tier 7. But, do you see a two radar? There's a two block is a radar, but... On the earlier version, if you shoot the radar, it's gonna damage the T-29.
Really?
So if you shoot a turret, they're gonna shoot your radar.
Okay. So that is the T-29. Alright. Okay. Oppie, he's trying to dodge bullets left and right. Even if we see Phoenix get this one tank out of the game.
Keep shooting them.
Right.
But,
there we go.
Wow! Going. Hit!
Yeah, that is finding a needle in a haystack. is what hitting that shot is like. And of course, you can see with how much time is left on the clock.
Yep.
That in many ways, I mean, Phoenix is they're hard pressed to do something about this.
Mm-hmm.
And they have to take down every tank on the enemy team to get the win. Now I feel like capture is almost completely unviable at this point.
Mm-hmm. They have to rush right now, or they're gonna lose this one. But how to rush is really, really critical and hard right now.
The pressure is on, and the commander is not making any, I wouldn't say ultra solid decisions.
Wow.
He is making, I mean, Blade is pushing forward just a little bit here,
mm-hmm.
and so is the rest of the team, it looks like, but it's just absolutely massive.
But, you know, if they want to do this, the main purpose about the Fenix team is want to kill the T29 first. But if they kill that, they only have 2 minutes. They want to capture. Okay, if they want to capture, they have to set up a defense line, but they don't have time right now.
This is not looking good. Plateau is actually getting hit there quite a bit, I might add. He's at about 55% of his whole integrity, and he does manage to exchange just that much HP for Blade.
Wow.
He's already at half HP anyway. There's going to be a nice little surround, I guess you could say, coming in here from 3 tanks versus 2.
Yeah, and they got an MS-50 on the south. Maybe cannot get there on time, so... Oh, I think the Phoenix team got big problem here.
Yeah,
they got to win our tiebreaker.
They have to basically kill all of Charlotte Tiger before 40 seconds is up. Hiwami's got a road to almost escape.
Oh, he ran away.
He can probably get Griven and run for his life if he's lucky, but that is a big F. And now he's backing up straight into Nissa. And Nisa's got a straight shot at the turret or the rear. All right, so as it is right now, there's only Lobos, Polly, and Reno remaining. Lobos is full HP.
Yeah, but he's 17 seconds. And M30, oh.
It's gonna take amazing coordinated fire to get that. It looks like, it's hard to say. It's 4 versus 2 in this scenario, essentially. And right now, I mean, Lobos is still alive. 2 seconds are here, and one tank is remaining. That means Charlotte Tiger gets the win.
Yeah.
Yeah. A little bit unfortunate.
Because they waste too much time on T29. But, you know, if they can do that earlier, that could be great. But, you know, finally, it's not working out because of the T29, he shift too much time. I mean, they know, like, you know your enemy and your turret, right?
Right.
So you can wait him for like 10 seconds. You know, after no one spotted you, it go out. 1 second, then go back. So you got a lower chance to be penetrated your commander tower, let's say.
Basically,
yeah.
I mean, yeah. Checking the score right now, it's 4-3 in favor of Charlotte Tiger. That means if Phoenix wants to win tonight's match, they're going to have to win not only this game, but the tiebreaker.
Mm-hmm.
And the next game is ultra critical because it determines whether or not we are going to a tiebreaker.
Yep.
That is the question that remains.
And, you know, it's a, they are on the assault side. It's really hard here, but I think they got pretty nice chance today. You know, every time, even they lose, you know, it's somewhat like counter, like you say. You know, but originally the idea is really nice, I have to say. And every time they almost win this one, almost.
Yeah.
But you know, the time remaining do not control really well.
Well, I mean that's how do I say this? It's this game, in about a 2 minute summary. So, I mean, the question is, are they going to take the next game or not? We're going to have to find out after a 90-second break, guys.
Okay.
Don't go away. All right, guys, this is it. This is that ultra-critical game. This is the one that determines whether or not we're going to have a tiebreaker tonight.
Yep.
So the question remains, will we see Phoenix get the win or not? We got two Chinese 110s coming from the NIAS, three VK2801 as they choose. Like, they always have it there. Two AMX 50s, and that's it. Oh, wait, yeah, single IS.
Yeah, I'd say, like, the same setup.
686?
Yeah, but this time they won't use the VK2801 there because of, you know, actually the T29 do not got really nice vision. So if he see the T29 there, just ask someone, you know, blind shot there. You know, I mean, not only blind shot, they can aim the window, not window, the gap, and trying to damage the T29. And if they got it, maybe kill 29, and they can rush earlier. But this time, I bet the Shaw Tiger, they got another counter strategy. So we are waiting for that, you know.
We got something coming from our production crew. I'm not entirely sure what it was all about. They told us to wait just a moment. Yeah, but, of course, we got two T-32s coming out from Charlotte Tiger, two AMX-50s, one IS-3, one KV-3, and, again, that T-29. They're going with the 5-8-7 composition this time around.
Yeah, S7 and Elite. On the fantasy team, they got VK-2801. So that's the same on the previous match, but this time, I don't think they're going to use a VK2801 on the capture circle, I think.
All right, I'm a little bit surprised we haven't had any disconnects this evening. I mean, once you stop and think about it.
But no one disconnected.
Yeah. I mean, we haven't had any disconnects this evening. I mean, you stop and think about it. It seems to happen about once every week. But, come on. When we're talking about team games, I mean.
But, you know, last time is Yilong.
Yeah.
Because they're from China.
Right.
So the internet might.
I thought the last time it was TCSG from Singapore.
Singapore, but that's weird. It's Singapore.
Yeah. I mean, that's where the server is located, for crying out loud, in APAC, right?
The ping time should be less than 20 or something.
Yeah. Less than 7, maybe. I don't know. Mm. But I mean, like, once we're talking about esports for starters, we're typically talking about 5 versus 5 formats. It's the most common format, if you will, for most esports titles. And then you've got the observer accounts, and then you've got, maybe someone else to throw in there, maybe a referee who's in-game. And, like, that brings it again to, like, 13 accounts for standard. But for us, it's, like, 17, because, well, of course, we've got 7 versus 7, we've got the two observer accounts, and we've got our own observer account. But something came in from our production crew. We're going to need, like, 5 minutes?
Yeah, but, you know, okay.
So telling us now, basically, we just need to, I guess you'd say we'll be ready in just a minute, is our understanding.
Yeah, but you know, this time they have the same setup. That means Phoenix team, they feel we're almost done, so they're going to try that again. But as you say, we might see the Shadow Tiger on the counter strategy there, but they only have maybe five minutes to create a new strategy, not that easy. They cannot make the same mistake as a step. Right.
I mean, essentially, yeah.
I'm talking about when they rush, but they go to the lower ground, and you know, get a lot of fire from every side. So, I know. You know, if you see a strategy really nice, you're kind of afraid about that. But you know, before you do something about counter, you still have to, you know, think that more clearly. You know.
Yeah. Well, here we go. We're at the loading screen, right? Or we're already past the loading screen.
Yep.
So, again, spawning to the south on offense is going to be Team Phoenix, and to the northwest on defense is going to be Charlotte Tiger.
Yep.
Now, I think that the only problem there with the last game coming from Phoenix was, of course, they didn't have a way to rapidly or effectively and quickly deal with that T29 camping in the hangar at the northwest end of the map. So, or excuse me, the abandoned train station, whatever have you. But I'm thinking if they can do something about this strategy and make it work just a little bit faster here in offense game number 2, then they've got a shot at their tiebreaker. All right. They are off once again, and looks as though Griven's going to get in to scout. Wait a minute. The rest of Phoenix is taking a different route this time around, it looks like. And... Griven might just be there to give them the idea that they're going in this direction because this is what they did in game number 1.
Yeah, I'm thinking about if they need the 100 second. I mean, VK capture.
Right.
Now, here, tier 6, right? Mm-hmm. So if they want to reset, here is a tier 8. Here is a tier 7. At least he can check one tank. So when they rush, maybe they can take one tank advantage.
So, of course, there he is. He's just camping in, I guess you could say, that little western position. I think maybe some members of Charlotte Tiger saw him. But, of course, the light bulb mod is not working right now. That means if the enemy team spots some, or if one team spots someone from the other team, the person that is spotted will have their light bulb light up. And that part of the mod, unfortunately, is not working today.
Okay, you know, this one capture here, making up a defense line.
I like that idea.
Yeah. But why not, you know, if they can go to the other side.
Alright, here we are. The push is coming just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, what is the move to be made? I mean, right now, Griven, he's painfully close to that capture circle. He's not in it just yet. And, I feel like he's just waiting for the commander to give him the order, and then he'll just dive right in. But wait a minute, he's actually going around back for some scouting, it looks like?
Yep. They want to see someone if here.
Track shot on Blade, and that did a lot of damage. That did a huge number to him. He's down to about a quarter of his original HP.
Oh!
Another shot bounces.
Pin damage, right?
Maybe, yeah, just but now on Nissa.
Shoot Nissa.
Right, Nisa's out of the game. A little bit of friendly fire, and of course, his cohort, Bingo Bongo, not far behind, does follow him to the grave. Griven now going around back to that counter, I guess you could say. He's down to half HP, fighting versus Polly now, and Polly's gonna. He says Polly doesn't want to crack her, and Polly wants to crack you out of this game. Now it's only four tanks remaining on Team Phoenix versus the six, albeit some of them low HP tanks of Charlotte Tiger. Four minutes are on the clock.
Yeah. But, you know, they're match 7, I think, is much better than this one. Okay, so, if they want to do this, they should capture. When you capture a check enemy's attention, then push. It's much better. But if they push directly, the VK2801 cannot offer too many support there.
Well, I mean, they've been given lemons, and now they're trying to make lemonade with it.
Yeah.
But it looks like that idea simply may not be working to their advantage at this moment. We've got Rodak, of course, about 50 HP. He's going to take that window and try and exchange fire as best he can. Opolis is going to prevent that push from coming. Fresh meat coming around for a flame.
Yeah, but Opolis didn't see him.
Nice hit there. And Opolisk repositions himself appropriately. Rodak's going to maybe try and get the hit on him. Does do a little bit of damage.
Yeah, but you know, actually, the hit point not that different, but, you know, Phoenix team still got a lot there.
Oh!
It can close right now.
Here we are. I mean, that's one shot on Opolisk right now. And now Blade is finally gone. He lived a long time at one shot. There's two one-shots, I might add, on Charlotte Tiger. So if we can see them somehow get those miracle hits, they might be in a great spot. Fresh Meat's going to go ahead and initiate that capture. Brilliant idea, given that Polly is one-shot. If he can just make one hit.
But they rush out. They know the Fresh Meat is reloading. Because you are reloading, so why not capture?
Wait. Sponster and Rodak are trying to make a magnificent hold here. It's a 2-3, but now it's 1-3. Rodak's doing what he can. But I mean, let's be straight here. When we're talking 1v3, that's as good as one against the world. Fresh Meat is the last tank alive.
Mm-hmm.
He's in the AMX-50, and he's gonna need a lot of love from RNGesus to get the win.
Yeah.
Just going Rambo, YOLO swag with that AMX-50. It looks like he's gonna be chased, and perhaps even shot at from the rear. But he can.
Wow.
Mommy spots him, but of course, it was not him who got the kill. Well,
I feel the Charlotte Tiger, you know, they are strong. Because they have hard time to face the three team from Silver. Horseman, almost tiebreaker. This one, almost tiebreaker. Formation in tiebreaker, you know.
You know what? I think the Yomi effect did not quite work out so much here on the last two games of defense.
Mm-hmm.
This is why I talked about earlier today. Mm-hmm. Himmelsdorf is one of the most frequently played maps in all of the WGL.
Mm-hmm.
We see that, I mean, not only does Charlotte Tiger have a lot of experience on this map, they're most comfortable playing it. I wouldn't be surprised to see that it was actually them mm-hmm. who picked this map.
Yep.
And maybe even, I would say, Phoenix didn't want to play them on Himmelsdorf. I wouldn't be surprised to find that out at all, but it's just the way this pans out. Charlotte Tiger, they're solid. They're indestructible on this map. We've seen it, you know, in the Silver Series, mm-hmm. or not Silver Series, but the Gold Series of Season 2, and now mm-hmm. the Gold Series here of Season 3, and this is what got them the end score of 5-3. As you mentioned before, they've got solid interpersonal, or they've got solid personal skills.
Mm-hmm.
There we go.
Mm-hmm.
And the amount of damage, the amount of coordinated fire, the skills, their commandeeringness, everything, it just can't be conquered, I feel. And I think they're one of the teams that's guaranteed a spot at WGL Season 3 Grand Finals, wherever it may be.
Mm-hmm.
But as we saw with the standings, Team Efficiency and Elong are leading. Maybe it's going to be Charlotte Tiger up there with them pretty soon, huh?
Yeah, but, you know, I feel, do you know, even the Team Efficiency and Elong, they're also doing the training, practice training, you know, because of...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because of... they still have to, you know, try new strategy. But Elong, even on the team training, still really, really super.
Yeah.
Really tough.
I mean, like, they have their own dormitories. They have their own training center, right?
Yep. Right.
They do. I mean, like, they eat, sleep, and breathe World of Tanks. they have the resources and the advantages that other teams in APAC don't really
compared
have.
Compared to the other one, because they can communicate on the same noon. You know, they don't need any communicate so far, because sometimes even so far got late.
Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm.
That's to be expected. I mean, mm-hmm. a lot of groups use WT fast to get around that, though.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that brings it to a wrap. End score 5-3. I'm a little bit disappointed we didn't at least see a tiebreaker or maybe even a total upset coming from Phoenix. That would have been great.
Yeah, but Himmelsdorf is really hard and you need more personal skill, literally, and teamwork.
And I feel like, you know, for every strategy that Phoenix had for this map, it feels as though Charlotte Tiger had 10 different strategies they could have thought of. So, I mean, if Phoenix had 10 different strategies for this map, maybe Charlotte Tiger had 50 or 100 strategies.
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So... Again, that's mm-hmm. it for tonight, guys. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, Front Mission did not show up on time, so they've been disqualified. And that being said, we're done for the night. So, we're on break until when? What? We're not going to be here next week.
We got 2 week break.
We have a 2 week long break, guys. Mm-hmm. So, let me check the date on my computer over here. We will be back in business on December 30th, if I'm not mistaken.
Let me check it.
December 30th?
December 30th, yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll be back in business on December 30th. Until then, my name is Benjamin Breaker Novotny.
This is Edison 99.
And we will see you guys on December 30th.
Have a good night.
Good night, guys.
Bye.